Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video, we will learn how to install Apache Kafka on Windows. And we'll do some changes in its configuration file. And then we will see how to create the topics and how producer will send the message. And then consumer will consume the same message from the topic. That all we will see in this video. Okay, let's start to download the Apache Kafka. So first we need to go to browser, and here we will type Apache Kafka download and click on the first link, download Apache Kafka. And here we will download its latest version. So here we will click on 2.13. And here we will click on this link, then download will be start. Okay, so once the download is complete, go to download folder and extract this file here. So here I will select extract here. And after extracting, we will open it, and we can see here it contains bin folder, config folder and libs folder. So we will just copy this, or we can cut from here and go to our C drive and paste here in C drive. And we can rename this also and use its name as a Kafka. So now I will open it, and here we can see bin folder, and bin folder contains the all SSH files, and for Windows it contains these all bat files. Bat means batch file. These all files will be used for Windows. When we will run the Zookeeper and will start the Kafka server, then these files will be used. And config folder contains all configuration properties file. So here we will do some changes. First we will open Kafka zookeeper.properties file. So click edit with notepad plus. And here we will see data directory folder is temp folder. So here we will change it from temp to C drive Kafka folder. And this will be zookeeper logs, and save it and close it. Now go to server.properties and edit with notepad plus, and here we will go and check the logs folder. So here it's also containing temporary folder, and we will change this folder, and here we will use C Kafka Kafka logs, and now close it. And the third one is libs folder that contains all the library related to zookeeper and Kafka. So now I will go to our bin folder, and then we'll go to Windows folder. And here we need to start first zookeeper, then we can start only Kafka server. So to run zookeeper server, so first here I will click and type cmd. Now here I am inside Kafka bin Windows folder, and here I will type the command that will be used to run our zookeeper. So here I will type zookeeper server.batch file, and here I will type Kafka, and it is the my folder. Here it contains config folder inside Kafka and zookeeper dot properties file. It will read while running. So now I will click on enter. So it's saying zookeeper dot server dot bat file is not available. Okay, then I will go, and here we need to add zookeeper dot server dot start and enter. Now our zookeeper will start. And after starting the zookeeper, we can only start Kafka server. So here we will allow access. Now I will go to again same folder, minimize it, and here we can see our zookeeper has started. Now I will click, and now we need to run our Kafka server because our zookeeper has already started. So here I will type Kafka server start, Kafka server start dot bat file, and its property file path is c slash kafka and slash config, and inside config it contains server dot properties file that contains its configuration. So click enter. Now here we can see Kafka has started. Now what we need to do, now we will create some topics. So here again I will click cmd and click enter, and now I will create few topics in our Kafka server. So here I will type Kafka topics dot bat and hyphen hyphen create, and here I will use zookeeper and its localhost port that is defined inside its config file. Zookeeper localhost port is 2181, port is 2181, and replication factor will be used 1. Replication factor here we are using 1, and then its partitions that will be 1, and here we will define the topic name. So the topic name will be any name we can give. So here we will give test topic and click enter. So here we can see created topic test topic, and then we will create one more topic like test topic 2. So topic created, and here we can see two topics are created. Now if we want to check the list of all topics, then we will type Kafka topics dot batch, topics dot batch and hyphen hyphen list, and then zookeeper and its port, zookeeper localhost 2181. So here we can see list of topics that we have created. So here we can see two topics, test topic and test topic 2. Now what we will do, we will create one console producer. We will open one console producer and we'll send the message to this topic. And then we will create one more console that will be act as a consumer, that will consume all the message from its producer. So here, go here and click cmd and enter. And now first I will create console producer. So to generate console producer, here I will type Kafka console producer batch. So producer will produce the message and consumer will consume it. And here I will type broker hyphen list, broker list, and localhost port is, default port is 9092. And we can change it, go to its server.properties file, hyphen hyphen topic, and our topic name is test topic. So now the producer will send the message to this topic, test topic. Now here I will click enter. So here our producer console is created. Now I will go to my folder again, and here I will generate Kafka consumer console also. So both will be used at same time. So here I will type Kafka hyphen console and consumer dot bat file bootstrap hyphen server, and its default port is 9092 and the topic name that we have created, and producer will send the message to this topic only, test topic. And if you want to get all the message from beginning, then here I will type from beginning, from hyphen. Now click enter. Here, this is our Kafka console and consumer console. And this is the producer console and this is a consumer console. So once I will send the message from producer, then consumer will consume this message. So here I will type hi. Then we can see here on consumer screen also the message hi is printed. Hope you are doing well. So here we can see this message because consumer is consuming this topic, test topic. So this is a producer console and this is a consumer console. Okay, this is all about how to configure and create the topics and send the message from producer and how the consumer will consume these all messages that we have covered in this video. And the next video we will create Kafka producer with Java code and we'll also create Kafka consumer. Okay, thanks for watching this video.